and I think life-changing experience for most of the people that come here. It's not easy to leave your country. It's not easy to come here or to go anywhere else where you don't know nothing about anything. So you're just completely lost. And this is totally life-changing, as Henrik says, but well, let's see. Yes. So you're wondering who and who's that and why she's talking to us. My name is Estefania. You can find me everywhere in Instagram or Twitter as Sarah, like my two last names. I come from Colombia. Very proud of Latin American people. And this is us, my group, the year. Last year. We were just sitting here, 1st of September too, same day. I think it was also Friday. And we took this picture right after we went out of here. Then we took this other picture in May, after we had gone through classes with Henrik, with classes with the rest of the people here at BMJX, and we were totally different people in so many ways. You can even see how tied up we were in that picture, like being nice, good kids. And then in the other picture, we were just more relaxed. We knew each other already, more of us. Some of us were already good friends, and that's something that's gonna change for this year. So, when Bettina asked me to make this presentation for you guys today, I said, well, where do I start? So I asked myself, what do I know now that I didn't know exactly 1 year ago when I was sitting up there around that corner, wondering what the hell is coming right now? And there are many, many things academically in my field as a journalist, as a person, but I certainly didn't know how to move. God, I feel so proud of myself. Very nice. I didn't know I knew how to bike, but you think you know how to bike until you come to Denmark, buy a bike, and start biking, and you say, I know nothing. What is this? What is this? People going smoking, talking to the phone, and driving at the same time, not even touching the direction, and I couldn't even pass the obstacles. Now I know to do a lot of things in my bike. I'm taking my bike to London, wrapping it in my bag, putting it on the plane, because I love to bike. That's some of the things that Denmark changed for me. I think if I can, I will never take public transportation again, if I can, if the city allows me. But that's not the biggest accomplishment on a bike. This is Sonia, friend of ours, from last year too. She literally didn't know how to bike. She had never stepped on a bike before. And this is her after 1 hour of training with a Brazilian friend. It's too bad that you cannot hear. I don't know if we can turn on the volume somehow. Or...
So was that Sonia's only journey?
No. That was just 1 hour after she started. Maybe if you could... Maybe we can hear the video later. At the end, she said, I can balance. She's just screaming, I can balance. And after a while, she just came to class on her bike, and we were all very proud of her. I think that this is the best place in the world to bike. If you know, go ahead for it. If you don't know, don't get afraid. Don't get scared because you don't.
There you go.
Take that opportunity, and that would be my first advice for you, bike. Do it. At least if you feel like it's definitely not for you, at least you said, okay, I gave it a try. But that's just one thing that in here you get all the chance to do. Then there's another important thing in Denmark. I don't know, in Latin America, in some other places of the world, we have a big meal at lunch, midday. In here, in Denmark, people don't really have a big lunch, they have a big dinner. But it's a whole culture having a dinner in Denmark. You go and cook with people, you arrange a meeting, you go to the kitchen together, everybody puts their hands on the dinner, and it's a moment to get cozy, to get vivid. And you will know what that is very soon. And I want to show you some pictures. This is all people from last year, and you'll see everybody on a kitchen all the time. Because this is a very nice way to get to meet each other. This is a very nice way to share a culture. And sometimes German friends of mine say, we want to try Colombian food. And I said, damn, but I don't cook. I mean, Colombian food is delicious, but my mom makes it, my grandma makes it. I have no idea how to make it. So I started calling my grandma, hey, how do I make coconut rice? And just on the phone. And I learned how to cook. And I learned a lot more things about cooking because I wanted to share that experience here with them. And I think that's my second advice for you, cook. Go ahead. You're gonna need it because you're not gonna starve anyways, and you're probably not gonna pay for food all the time. Improve it, take advantage of it, take advantage of your kitchen and from the people in here in Denmark that know how to cook very well, because Danish people really appreciate good food, just as Bettina. They appreciate good food and they know how to make it, so probably you learn something from it. Then, okay, I think you've heard it already a lot, winter is coming and it is coming. It looks like it's not, but it is. And it's a hard season. And you're gonna start feeling that you're getting lazy, that you don't wanna go anywhere, that you don't wanna do anything, that you don't wanna take a call. I'm being a bit dramatic here, but it could be like that. And when I went through winter, I said, what am I doing in Denmark? But I was asking myself for real, what am I doing in Denmark? What did I come here to do? Because I have to find some motivation to wake up, right? So, hey, what? I'm already here, so what did I come here to do? Don't forget, you're here to study. We all left all our lives, quit our jobs, said bye to our families and friends, because we came here to study, right? And that woke me up in the morning during winter. I said, I'm going to class, because that's gonna give me a reason to wake up, that's gonna give me a reason to meet my friends. After class, you probably get some invitations for dinner. You say, hey, why don't you come meet us tomorrow? So you're gonna get your activity going. And that's the most important thing in the winter. Get it going. Don't stay in your room. Go outside. Do things. And going to class is gonna keep that flow of activity going. And they are not paying me for saying this. Well, about the grades, I think maybe you'll get that whole explanation afterwards when you get the boring presentation on Tuesday. Mm-hmm. But basically what you need to know is the Danish system is totally crazy. It's nothing like you've ever seen before. It has like these 12 grades, and if you get a 12, congratulations. If you get a minus 3, please let me know what did you do, because I don't know how you can get a minus grade ever. But you're probably gonna be around the adequate, fair, and good grade, and that could be very disappointing at the first time you get a grade, because you said, I was so sure I was going to get that 12, because back in my country, that work that I did was very, very good work. But maybe for these standards, it's just fair, or it's just good. So my advice for the grades is, don't take it personal. This, you're gonna get to know the system while you go through the classes, and it might be a little bit disappointing or surprising at the beginning, but you will get to understand the system. And then, which of you think I have an accent? Do you have an accent? Well, breaking news, you also have an accent. All of you. Because we, in here in this program, we don't speak English. We speak international English. We speak something that we try to understand, all of us, but we all have an accent, everybody here, and yet you don't even know how smart I am, Ms. Fox. Like, and sometimes you want to participate in class, but you really cannot put together the argument, and you need that exact word that you don't know how to say in English, then just stand up and say, who else in here speaks Spanish? Come on, let's just work it out and help me say Spanish. I cannot say it, and I know a lot of people that didn't participate in class because they were a little bit ashamed of their accent, or because they thought that maybe they didn't have the vocabulary to say, because you have very existential, you need a big vocabulary in English to express yourself and make an argument. If you can't, just find somebody that speaks your native language and go ahead with it. Because in here, everybody will appreciate your participation and everybody will understand that nobody here has perfect English. And native English speakers also will understand that we are making something that they are not. that is frustrating having to translate in our minds, right? So this is a place where you get that tolerance, where you get that acceptance. Mm. So five, it's participate. Don't hesitate. And so, like, to resume, bike, cook, go to class, don't take the grades personal, and participate. I want to, there's two things I didn't put here, and I want to give you these two advice for me, is meet the people. Don't sit in the same place with the same people all the time. Try to switch places in class, get to know each other, because last class in May, with my friend Bernard from Mexico, you say, is there somebody here that you didn't speak to at all during this year? And we say, yeah, that girl was there, and then there's this other guy, I don't know, we never talked, we never said hi. How come in 9 months, you never said hi to somebody in your class? I think this is something that I would recommend. Try as much as you can to meet everybody in the program. Explore the city, Aarhus is beautiful, there's a lot of things to do, and you say, I have a year. Right, the touristic stuff I'm gonna do next year, doesn't matter. I'm going to Aarhus just now. I've been here a year and I haven't been to Aarhus because I just said I have a whole year. It goes very fast. It's 9 months, and when you realize you gotta go and you didn't see the touristic things, for example, here now. So explore the city. And the third and last thing from my side is check on the visa requirements for your next year with time. Very ahead, because now I'm seeing a lot of friends of mine going to Amsterdam, going to Hamburg, that just now are making their applications because they didn't know they had to, because something went wrong, because they didn't have the right information. So be very careful and research very well what you need for your next year applications with a few months before. And some friends of mine from my program sent you small videos, so you didn't have to hear me only in this presentation, so here we are.
Hi, this is Eileen from Manila, and I would like to welcome you to the Mundus family. In this program, you will meet the best persons, the most brilliant ones you'll ever meet in your life, and I hope you get what you wish to get out of the program, whether it's friendship or good grades or diploma or skills and experiences. Hope you get it. Have fun!
Welcome to the first year of the master's program. And we should have a study, work, and social life travel balance. And just enjoy the first year.
I'm Luis Suarez from Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. And about a year ago, I was in your shoes, freshly arrived in Denmark and just wondering, well, what's next? We live in the best and worst of times to be a journalist. And you're in a privileged position because you have the opportunity to discuss everything that's going on, not only in our professional field, but in the field of politics, globalization, economics, culture. Enjoy the city, enjoy the people sitting next to you. There, remember, you're not the flags in your passport. You are all Mundusians, and that's a very special bond that you are carrying for the rest of your lives.
Hey everyone, my name is Michael. What do you think about journalism and making contacts for life? This program presents a very good opportunity. So I encourage you to make the best of this 1 year, get to know each other, because I think that relationships like this that we get as a result of this program are invaluable. So make the best of Denmark. It can be cold sometimes, but I believe that when you have each other, it becomes a lot more bearable. I wish you all the best. Enjoy your stay in Denmark.
That's Michael. He just left this morning on his bike to the UK. They are biking, Michael and two Dane guys, they are biking to the UK. They're going to Germany on the ferry and biking all the way to France and then taking the ferry again. 15 days biking. So, there you see. So thank you very much. Many thanks.